autism is a neurodevelopmental condition, which means that it's something that affects brain development. And people with autism have difficulties communicating and socializing with other people. And they can also have sensory sensitivities or behaviors that make it difficult for them to engage and interact with the world.
There are hundreds of autisms, and each of these autisms have similar behavioral manifestations. Autism is a big issue focus of our time. We're talking about these conditions which affect between 1 to 2% of people, so it's not rare. And being able to influence the lives of 1 to 2%, I think is fabulous.
So historically, it was thought that you cannot diagnose autism under 3 years of age, but that's not true. You can diagnose autism under 3, and in fact, you can do it as early as 18 to 24 months of age. So what we've tried to do is try to come up with innovative ways in which we can detect autism early so that we can diagnose early and begin intervention as early as possible.
The earlier you can get in before the syndrome is fully manifest, then I think the earlier you can really start to work with that child and stop the autism impacting on their ability to learn.
I'm Rita. My daughter Heidi's 11, and when she was 2.5, she was diagnosed with autism. Heidi's early diagnosis has meant that now that she's 11, Heidi's able to recognise some of the challenges she faces in the world. She's learnt from a very young age how to self-regulate her sensory issues so that she's aware of what her body's doing and she can communicate what she needs. And I really hope that as an adult, having had this amazing grounding in learning who she is from a very young age, that'll help her thrive as an adult, because she'll get out there and go, this is who I am, this is what I need. Being autistic's not a bad thing, it's just a part of me.
The ability to influence that developmental trajectory is much greater when the child is young. So what we want to do is we want to identify very early and start to intervene with that child so that the child develops the ability to communicate and communicate independently. So if we can get communication in there, if we can get language developing in there in those first 2 years of life, then we're on a much better pathway for that child.
So over the last 10 years, we've conducted 2 large scale studies in our maternal child health system. We've trained our maternal child health nurses on what the early red flags of autism are. We then wanted to come up with a really innovative way of bringing this world-class research to the world. So we developed an app called AS Detect, and it takes about 20 minutes to complete at each age, at 12, 18, and 24 months. And then it gives the parent an indication as to whether or not their child may be at high or low likelihood of autism.
At any one time, we have between 40 to 50 research studies underway at the centre. Some of the core research programs within the centre as of 2016 is in early identification and diagnosis, a research program on early intervention, and also how best to promote and help people with autism succeed in employment. For someone with autism to really thrive, it doesn't mean not having autism anymore. It simply means being able to reach their potential.
So really our ultimate aim is to not try and fix someone with autism, so to speak, but it's really about facilitating their development and ensuring that they're able to live the life that they want to live.
My hope for Heidi in the future as an autistic adult is that we've given her all the tools she needs to thrive. We've given her the self-awareness, the ability to advocate for herself, the understanding that autism is a strength, it's not a weakness, and then she can go out into the world and do amazing things, or just be happy.